Another time's gotta have someone.
Hi lovelies, it's me, Simply Sherry, making home and entertaining simple. This is the second episode of my kitchen tour series. I am going to be showing the kitchen sink area. Please make sure to check out the iCards above for other episodes in this series. I'm standing here in front of my kitchen sink, and this is the view that I normally have. That is our family room, and I do watch TV sometimes there when I'm cleaning or cooking. And then here to the right is the kitchen nook where we eat dinner daily. That's our backyard, and of course I have my umbrellas down there because it's just been windy off and on during the night and they just blow over. I like to keep this area here on top of the bar as clear as possible. I did change this up recently where I just put the fake orchid plant there, and then this bowl I love. I got it from this province in the Philippines called Vegan, V-I-G-A-N. And then I can fill this bowl with different seasonal fruits. Right now it's towards the end of summer, so I like to have lemons there. When the fall comes, I'll be putting apples. As you can see, I have a double sink. Here to the left is our Ninja, which where we make smoothies. I also have an attachment, like a food processor. I did have a tray here where I put fruit for our smoothies, but I've changed that out, and I'm just trying to keep this counter clear here and keep it clear here also. And then here you can see on top I have the dishwashing soap. This is an acrylic one and it's kind of getting nasty up here, so I might change that out, but I do like a clear one so I can see the contents inside. A sponge and then a dish wand. This is for pots and pans or whatever I want to scrub. My friend gave this to me. This is for a ring, but I like to keep this on top there. Hand soap and then hand lotion, and I just like to keep it on a tray. Then I also like to put a kitchen towel here. This has been used this morning already, but I just like to drape it over there. And then I have these two over the door towel holders that I have screwed into the cabinet here on top. And then I just got these new kitchen towels for the fall. They're like a gray pumpkin. And then these are just fake drawers, but I still put the knob here. So these knobs or these drawer pulls are from Restoration Hardware. These over the towel racks are from Ross. So in this top drawer, as I mentioned in my other video, the drawers in my kitchen are not deep and wide. You can see that they are pretty shallow and then not very deep. So those are my other drawers. You can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I have 10 total drawers. Here I have ties, like zip ties, and then sometimes you have ties from like bread and you don't know what to do with that tie, so just leave them in here and they can be reused. I do have some of these small plastic jewelry bags if you need a little packet to go, like you have a potluck and you need to put a little bit of a sauce, or sometimes like chili flakes or Parmesan cheese, you want to just throw it in there and then finish your dish at the potluck dinner, and then you could either reuse this, you know, kind of wash it out, especially if it's just spices, nothing liquid. Okay, these are covers. They are like the, you know, the covers that you put on your head in the shower. Shower caps. Okay, but they're covers especially made for bowls. And of course, you can get the shower caps at the Dollar Tree. But I forgot what brand that is. You can get that at any grocery store. These organizers are from Target. They're the Room Essentials brand. And then this is for the quart freezer, quart storage, sandwich, and snack. And so what I've done is at the bottom of these containers, I've just labeled it their snack. If you're used to Ziploc, I think they're wonderful. What they did was they color coded. So you can see the green, the pink, and the blue. Green is for snack sandwich, pink is for storage, blue is for freezer. So they have the freezer gallon one also. I've just labeled the bottom of each of these containers so that when this is running out, I or anyone in my family or even a guest knows what belongs there. Quart storage is quart freezer. Now my overflow Ziplocs, I take them out of the box and I keep them in a shoe holder that's in the back of the laundry room door. Especially like if you go to Costco or wholesale places and you get a whole bunch of them, you need a place for overflow because they're not all gonna fit in this drawer. And then here I have it labeled gallon. And then you can also see that I have drawer liners in all of my drawers. I put it all kind of in the same direction And then I just fold it, and then fold it again, and then I fold it in half as it goes into the little container there. Okay, so that's the top drawer. This drawer is where I keep the kitchen towels and rags. It's a little bit taller in that way, and then, but it's the same depth. And again, I have the drawer liners there. So I just keep the kitchen towels here. These are new because, as you can see here, they start getting dirty. And then these towels are rags. They're hand towels. And what I do is, in the guest bathroom, I have hand towels like this. These are the older ones. So they're not as white and clean anymore for guests. So when those get kind of dingy or ratted up, or see, you can see that's pretty dirty, but I've been using that as a rag now. So those towels from the guest room come over to here, and then they become rags. Okay, so, and then the bottom drawer, since it's at the bottom, it's stuff that I don't use a lot. So I do have candles here that I like to burn more during the fall and winter. And then I have my Pampered Chef oven mitt here, which is fantastic. Then I just have some more rags there. These are sponge cloths. And then I also have some stuff here from Globe Inn. This is the towel to wipe up the cast iron pan. I know it looks dirty, but it's just stained. And then some chamois and microfiber cloths. This is a gift my friend gave me. We use sometimes when we're baking. That is the third drawer. And under the sink area, I've already done a video showing how I organized it. So I'm going to put a link in the iCards above if you want to see it more in detail. It's pretty much the same setup that I have, where I have an overdoor holder here with my barkeeper's friend that I use to clean the sink. Some brushes. I usually have my dishwashing liquid here. I just need to replenish that. Two containers for some copper scrubbers, and then also wall erasers. Spray bottles that I've done, which have more of the natural cleaners. Cleaning wands from the Dollar Tree, microfiber. One is for electronics like TV, the other is for furniture like the couches and also the blinds. Bleach pods here, that's what I use to clean the sink. Extra sponges, more sponges, gloves, and the sponge for the dish wand. Toothbrushes with containers to clean the nooks and crannies of the sink. Baseboard, and then also the cabinets. And then a scraper for cleaning the stove. I have command hooks here for my oven mitts, cleaning gloves. This cleans my cast iron pan. It works so well. Please check out the description box for different items that I'm showing in this video that I think you might be interested in, or I want to recommend to you. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you're new to my channel, please hit the subscribe button. I'd love to have you on this journey with me to making home and entertaining simple. Please leave a comment below and let me know how you organize your Ziploc or food storage, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye! You make me smile. You like good food. You're from that place.